Good evening, and welcome to our celebration, the evening Mass of the Lord's Supper. My name is Will Sweet, and I will be your reader along with Carolyn MacDonald. This is the beginning of the Triduum, and is celebrated today throughout the world. Our presider is our Bishop, Wayne Joseph Kirkpatrick, celebrating together with our rector, Father Danny McLennan. This will be a wonderful parish celebration. Our Eucharistic ministers are Donnie MacDonald and Greg Fraser, and our altar servers are Anto Christopher, Eon Syriac Baiji, and Evelyn Afonso Baiji. The holy oils blessed at the Chrism Mass will be presented to our parish by Karen Go Mariano, Alpheus Kabila Tazan, and Anna Katrina Aguila. We wash feet as Jesus did and follow the call to serve one another. As well, we will celebrate the institution of the Eucharist, when Jesus took bread and broke and gave it, and then took the cup and shared it. We follow his instruction to do this in memory of me. After the communion prayer, we will all kneel, and the Blessed Sacrament will be carried throughout the church and brought to the vestry, where we will watch and pray. This follows the example of the disciples who went with Jesus to the Mount of Olives. At 10 p.m. tonight, night prayer will be prayed. We will return tomorrow, Good Friday, at 3 p.m., to continue our Triduum. Please join Saint Ninian Choir under the direction of Emery van de Wiel in our gathering hymn, number 382, When I Behold the Wondrous Cross, number 382.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, we've completed our Lenten observance and begun the solemn celebration of the sacred Triduum. Well, on these great days, it's our duty to glorify in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whom we have salvation, life, and resurrection. Tonight, we're going to receive the three oils that were blessed and consecrated here in our cathedral on Monday, the Mass of Chrism. And with them, the sick will be anointed, those awaiting waters of rebirth will be strengthened, those anointed to be baptized, to confirm, share in the mission of Jesus, the Anointed One, and by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, who filled these oils with life and grace, the saving work of Jesus Christ is continued in the Church. And so I now invite the oil bearer for the oil of the sick to come forward. And may the sick who are anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body, mind, and soul. Thank you. And now invite the bearer of the oil of catechumens to come forth. Through anointing with this oil, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms. Thank you. I now invite the bearer of the oil of sacred chrism to come forth. Through anointing with his perfumed chrism, may children and adults who are baptized and confirmed, and those who are ordained, experience God's gracious gift of the Holy Spirit. Thank you. So now we have officially received the oils into our cathedral parish. As I mentioned, tonight we begin the sacred 3 days of the Triduum as we celebrate the Mass of the Lord's Supper. And we hear in the Gospel how Jesus showed how perfect his love is for us. So let us prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, the Passover of our Lord, by acknowledging that we too have been slaves to sin, that we need deliverance by the blood of the Lamb. Lord Jesus, you saved us by the power of your cross. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give us yourself in the sacrament of your body and blood. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you destroy death forever through your resurrection. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his saving love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for every family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat of it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year-old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat that lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I shall execute judgment. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the homes where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the lands of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord throughout your generations. You shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord.
Blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ. The blessing cup that we bless is a of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the Lord's name. My vows to the Lord I will before all his people. The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin. He began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not only my feet, but also my hands and my head." But Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. "For this reason," he said, "not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, put on his robe, and returned to the table, Jesus said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. At the Mass of the Lord's Supper, the Church focuses on three things: the institution of the Holy Eucharist, the institution of the priesthood, and Jesus' new command for his disciples to love one another and to imitate him. Saint John Paul II stated that there is no priesthood without the Eucharist, and there's no Eucharist without the priesthood. The Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke describe the Last Supper of Holy Thursday as a Passover meal, and therefore the first reading from the book of Exodus provides the instruction on how the Passover meal is to be celebrated. And for Jews, this event will be remembered and celebrated as the saving action of God, of how God delivered the Jewish people from slavery in Egypt, and how the angel of death struck down the firstborn of Egypt, but passed over the homes of those whose doorposts were sprinkled with the blood of the Lamb. So as a faithful Jew, Jesus was celebrating the Passover meal with his disciples. And Passover is commemorated annually by our Jewish friends, and this year Passover begins on the evening of April 22nd. In our Easter vigil, we preserve the Passover readings, which celebrate freedom from slavery in Egypt. And we recall the new interpretation given to the feast as freedom from the slavery of sin and death by the death and resurrection of Jesus. So Jesus is the Paschal Lamb led to the slaughter, and which is why before Holy Communion, the priest holds the host and says, "Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world." So as Jesus celebrated the Passover meal, he deviated from the traditional ritual, added his own words and actions over the bread and wine. And those words and actions are the content of tonight's second reading. Consequently, the Passover meal, the heart of the religious practice of Jewish people, became the heart of our celebration of the Eucharist for Christians. And the earliest record of what Jesus said and did at the Last Supper is recorded in today's second reading from 1 Corinthians. St. Paul remembers what has been passed on to him from the early church, and he indicated that he is handing it on just as he received it, unedited. And he records that Jesus took the bread and said, "This is my body that is for you." And he then took the cup of wine and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood." So these words and actions are to be carried on by Jesus' followers. And he said, "Do this in remembrance of me." So every time we gather to celebrate the Eucharist, we remember Jesus' words and actions. So the gift that Jesus left his disciples is the greatest gift that he could leave, is abiding presence, the gift of himself in the Eucharist. And every celebration of the Eucharist, we hear the words, on the night he was betrayed. Well, Holy Thursday is that night. Tonight we're presented with the Gospel according to Saint John. Unlike the other Gospels, John's Gospel does not focus on the institution of the Eucharist at the meal, the Passover. John places that earlier in chapter 6 with the bread of life discourse. Instead, John narrates the events of Jesus washing the feet of his disciples with that focus on service. So this act symbolizes his actions of healing and of reaching out to the poor, welcoming the stranger, giving new life to those crippled, leper, blind. At table, the night before he died, Jesus performs a symbolic act that really summarizes his whole life. He does what the lowest servant would do. He kneels and washes the feet of his disciples. So his message is clear. He has not come to assume a place of power in the world, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. So in one powerful ritual, Jesus really encapsulates the whole of his life's message for the disciples. You know, while they traveled with him, the disciples had seen him in loving ways. Jesus accepted the sick and the poor, the fragile, the outsiders. And if his disciples had taken to heart Jesus' ways throughout his ministry, they would not have been shocked, as Peter was, by the washing of their feet. After all, one way or another, he was always bending to wash the feet of others. So in the humble act of washing their feet, he gave them and us a very powerful message on how we are to live our Christian lives. His question to those with him is to us as well. Do you realize what I have done for you? So we ask that question, do we? Washing, serving, bending down, feeding, loving, listening, are all just the beginning of how Jesus is calling us beyond the upper room to implement a faith, hope, and love in our world. So foot washing is not just a ritual, but it's a way of being Christian in our world. So we learn to wash the feet of immigrants and strangers that we meet. We open our hearts to people without jobs, people who face mental illness. So there are many examples of people who have been deeply affected by Jesus' life and example and have devoted themselves to the service of the poor, the sick, the dying, children, the aged, prisoners, refugees, so on. So Jesus always wanted to help the needy and distressed in his life. And his example at the table before his death taught his disciples they must do the same. So Jesus calls us to be people of love and service in our world. Greatness in God's kingdom is seen in loving service to one another. So all are called to love one another, and love is paired with service. The Eucharist leads us to service of others. And with the foot washing, Jesus gives the mandatum, the new command, love one another as I have loved you. So being of service to one another is really the cornerstone of what it means to be a disciple of Christ, a Christian follower of Christ who came not to be served, but to serve. So as a sign of love and service in the faith community, it's rather appropriate tonight that we present the foot washing, that, and also that our parish formally received these blessed sacred oils. These oils will be used in the service of the community in celebrating the sacraments. So may the Lord Jesus continue to nourish us with the gift of the Eucharist, so that we may continue to serve one another in Christ. So may God bless you in your service to one another. We now proceed with the washing of the foot washing. So I invite those to come forward. Thank you. night before he died, the Lord gave his disciples a new example of love when he washed the feet and instituted the sacrament of the Eucharist. So in celebrating our three-day Passover, let us bring our needs before our gracious God as we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord,
for the Church, united in this Eucharistic banquet of praise and thanksgiving with Pope Francis and Bishop Kirkpatrick, and for all priests, religious, and deacons who are called to be an image of Christ's mercy in service and ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the baptized who are the body of Christ in the world, and for those who daily wash the feet of others by their mercy, service, and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who care for loved ones, especially those with dementia, and for our humble and charitable service to the poor and needy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Spirit's wisdom for leaders in the search of peace and hope for the people of Ukraine, Haiti, and the Holy Land, and for all Christians unable to celebrate this Eucharist this night because of illness, natural disasters, persecution, or lack of priests, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an environment and families that nurtures the call of God, and for all young people who seek God's guidance in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more priests, deacons, and religious to serve in our diocese, and for Jewish people throughout the world who remember the saving deeds of God in the Passover, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, hear our prayers and fill us with life through our sharing in this meal. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
salvation. Through your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It'll become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask to receive the sacrifice with humble and contrite hearts. May the Lord wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Thank you. Thanks very much. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father, may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. Is that mic in the right spot? Seems to be a little low. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. And as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints, We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate, order our days in your peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen.
Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all things good, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us share with one another some sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace with you. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so may we enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.